Welcome to Bee Monster Laboratory. Today we're going to learn how easy it is to build your own cat laser pointer toy using Arduino controlled servo motors. It'll contain two servo motors, one will pan left and right and one up and down, and that will control the laser diode. While we'll be using Arduino code to control the project, we'll be using a thumbstick or joystick to control the direction that we want the laser to go. We're going to make this project really fun, and I hope you stick around and check it out. Here's everything that I used for this project. I used two 9-gram micro servo motors, a breadboard power supply, two 5mm LED, and 220 ohm resistors attached to both, a joystick, a 5-volt laser diode, a 5-volt laser diode, a small push button to power that diode, and that's about it. You'll need a bunch of these male-to-male jumpers, and of course, some female-to-male jumpers. And also an Elegoo Mega board, a 2560, a Mega 2560, although you can use the other Arduino boards as well, but I'm using the Mega board. So that is it for components. Well, at this point, I'll just show you the wiring and the connections. Over here, we have the joystick, and this was in the Elegoo Mega 2560 kit that I purchased. So if you bought the same kit, you have one as well. Otherwise, you have to buy one separately. And there's 5 pins on this, and I'm using 4 pins. The ground pin, the 5-volt pin, the X, and the Y pin. So the ground and the 5-volt pin are just connected to the ground and positive rail here on the breadboard, while the X and Y pins are connected to analog 0 and 1, as you can see there. If you look over here, I've got the, this is a 5-volt laser diode I purchased off Amazon. Got a whole bunch of them. They are kind of flimsy and they do fall apart because they don't have much solder, as you can see there. And the wires are very small, very thin, but this one is intact and it works. And I have it connected to a mini hook. I don't know what you call these, mini hook. There used to be another end just like this, but it fell off. So I use that to put in the breadboard. It works out pretty well. And the positive is connected to one side of my button, my push button over here. And then the negative is connected to the breadboard right here, the negative rail of the breadboard. And the other side of the push button is a wire that's connected to the Elegoo board at digital pin 2. If we move on down here, we have two 5mm LEDs, and they are connected to the negative rail of the breadboard by a 220 ohm resistor, and the wire connecting both of these are connected to the Elegoo board pin number 4 and 5. And as we move our way up here, we will see two servo motors. It is the Muzi servo motor. It's a micro servo motor, 9-gram micro servo motor. Purchased 10 of these on Amazon. They seem to be okay. They were humming earlier, but I can't get them to do it again. So I don't know exactly what the deal was, but they're not humming currently. So these have 3 leads per servo. You've got a ground lead, you've got a positive VCC lead, and then you have a signal lead, the orange one. And the signal lead for both of these are in the Elegoo board pin number 9 and 10. The negative lead from both of these are going into the breadboard right here, into the negative rail. The positive VCC lead for both of these are going right into the breadboard down here, where they are connected to 5-volt breadboard power supply. So the blue and the green wire are the VCC for both of these servo motors. Now I'm currently supplying power to the Elegoo board using the 5-volt breadboard power supply. It does have enough juice to supply power to both. And the reason I used a power supply on the breadboard is because I'm using more than one servo motor. I don't like to connect too many motors to the Elegoo board As you can see, the 5-volt pin is connected to the positive rail here, which is 5-volt on the breadboard, and then the negative or ground pin right here on my Elegoo board is connected to the ground rail here on my breadboard. So that's my setup. Pretty simple.
Well, here's my version of the schematic. Hopefully it'll help you out if you have any questions about that.
I can power it on and move these right around. Up and down and left and right. Then if I press my button over here, I have the laser pointer. So everything's working perfectly. Now this is the part where I'm going to do a little bit of soldering. I'm going to use these wires and I'm going to solder these resistors onto these LEDs. And these LEDs are going to be eyes for my little robot head. Now I was going to do a bigger robot head that turned and looked up and down, but the wood kind of split on me, so I've been reduced to cardboard. But it'll work, and so I'm going to make the eyes here. I'm going to solder this together. I'm using green and red wires, 22 gauge, and I'm also using a 1.6 millimeter lead-free 97.3 rosin core solder. So you can get that on a spool. You can either, I think I got this at Walmart. So I just cut my wires from the spool here, and I'm going to strip off a little piece in the end for the breadboard, and another piece up here to solder against. So I'll make these cuts to all of them, and then we'll get soldering. So I'm going to solder it onto the long leg of my LED. So just separate that a little bit. Get my soldering iron. This is just a cheap Weller soldering iron. I think I actually got this at Walmart too. It's cheap, but it is reliable. And now I'm ready to solder my LED on here. You don't want to hold it on too long, you'll destroy it. Now if this were going to be permanent, I would use some shrink tubing to cover that so you don't get a lot of corrosion, but I'm just going to have fun with this for a while. And then I'll cut it off right here and toss the LED in the trash. But yeah, you'd want shrink tubing on here. Or I may keep the LED. It'll still be good. I'll just clip it off. But this is not going to be permanent.
Now I'm using my wire cutters to hold my wires in the air while I solder. So it's a new technique that I've never seen before. Now once you cover that LED lead with some solder, it just takes a moment to solidify. And normally I would trim these resistors down, but again, I'm just doing this for fun. I just kept these long leads on there. And here's my final product here. I just wanted to test it out and make sure it works, and indeed it does. Now I do like these craft boards here that you can get at Walmart. They're $4 or $5 for three of them. And I'm gonna glue two of these together just for stability. I also have a piece of wood that I found in the garage. I don't know, maybe from another project. I'm just going to put a little bit of glue on each end, maybe a little dab in the middle, and that should hold it pretty well. And if I need to add more, I can just add more later. Now I used that 3 millimeter craft board stuff that I used, and I cut up some squares. I'm going to glue those together and then put those right up against the servo motor to give it a little bit of stability while it's up here operating. And I just find a good placement for it. And I think right there in the center will do. I'm going to put some glue on the bottom here and then attach it to this piece of wood right next to the servo motor. And it does add quite a bit of stability. Now I'm going to glue a piece of this board here that I cut on top of the arm of the servo motor. You want to make sure that you have a screw in that servo motor arm so that it doesn't fall off later on. Now I'm adding a second servo on top here with glue, and that will be our up and down servo. The bottom servo will be our pan, left and right servo. Originally my design was going to be an alien face with red eyes, but as I was cutting the wood, the jigsaw split the whole thing in half, so I'm resorting to cardboard, which I don't like because cardboard is often flimsy and hard to work with, as I'm experiencing here. So I'm going to have to reinforce the back of this with some 3mm craft wood. Hot glue is not always going to be a great option, especially if you're working with cardboard and the load is a little heavy. It could break apart, which can make it frustrating. I should have just went back and recut another piece of wood and used some screws and nuts and bolts. That would have been ideal. Now it's time to hot glue the laser diode into the mouth of my little head figure here. And it's going to take quite a bit of glue to keep it stable. Not a big fan of what I'm doing right here, but I'm going to own it, right? It's going to work. I'm also putting some copper wire that I had to connect the face to the servo, which makes it really bouncy. So I'm going to have to stabilize it with another piece of wire attached to the other side of the head. Well, I'm not a huge fan of the way it looks, but it does serve its purpose, and the code works as it should. So functionally, it's good. Aesthetically, it's horrible. I think I should have went back and used a piece of wood instead of this horrible piece of cardboard. But everything else seems to be all right. I probably shouldn't have used these little hook things on the bottom, too, because they really get in the way when I use the joystick to move the head around. But, you know, aside from the looks, it looks like a third grader put it together. It does what it should. So, for this purpose, I guess I'm happy. Here's the code for this project. The good thing about it is that it's short and sweet, so that means I can probably put it in the comments section, you know, below the video on YouTube. Sometimes I can't do that. I do post all my code on the Facebook page, and you can go there. I'm going to start putting hashtags in with the code so that you can search for them easier. I know it's kind of a mess, but there's got to be a better way to do it. But anyway, code should be available on both the comment section and on the YouTube page. So if you haven't checked that out, make sure you do. Well, here we are, and I gotta say it works pretty well. There's a little extra movement in the head when you move the servos up and down and back and forth because of that copper wire that I attached from the servo to the head. But the cat seems to like that extra movement. The joystick is super sensitive, so you gotta move it a little slower. But overall, I'm pretty happy with it. If I were to do it again, I would definitely use the 3mm plywood that I usually use, and probably go with the nuts and bolts rather than hot glue, just because it's more stable.
Well, that's all I've got for today. If you happen to do this project, let me know how it went in the comments down below. Can't wait to see your comments. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.